Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 5.1, Problem 2. This is Section 5.1, Problem Number 2. It says an experiment has a sample space of the following equally likely outcomes. The sample space is 1 through 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Find the probability of each of the following events. And the 1 through 10, again, the equally likely, it says so right in the question. So the probability of getting an event or a result of just 7. Well, 7 is one of the things that can happen out of 10 altogether. So the probability would be 1/10. And that can be written as 0.1 or 0.10, or if you like, 10%. Any of those answers are acceptable. 1 over 10, 0.1, 0.10, or 10%. They all mean the same thing. Part B, what's the probability of getting a result of 7 or 8? So that's 2 out of the 10 possible outcomes that you could get. So it would be 2 over 10. If you like, you could reduce that to 1 over 5. You could write it as 0.2, 0.20, or 20%. Those all mean the same thing. You could leave it as 2 over 10 if you like, or any of the other forms. Part C, what is the probability of the event of 1, 2, 5, 7, 9, 10? Well, what you have to do is see how many items are in that event. If you count them, there are 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different outcomes out of 10 altogether. So it would be 6 over 10, which again, you could reduce if you like, you don't have to 3/5, right? Cut them both in half. Or you could say that it is 0.6 or 0.60 or 60%. Again, they all mean the same thing. If you stop at 6 over 10, that's fine. Some people like percents. You could do any one of those. Part D, what's the probability of your event having the outcomes 2, 3, 4, or 8? So again, the thing is that there are 4 possible outcomes for that event out of 10 things you could get altogether. So 4 that satisfy the event out of 10 that you can get altogether, 4 over 10, which could be reduced if you like to 2/5, or you could write it as 0.4 or 0.40 or 40%. They all mean the same thing. You could do any of them. E, what's the probability of getting a 22? 22 is not part of the sample space. It's not one of the outcomes. So you can't get a 22. It's impossible. Well, there's an answer for that. What's the probability of something that's impossible? The probability wouldn't be 0. So it's not as ridiculous a question as it seems at first. If you just can't get that outcome, probability is 0. And the other extreme is part F. What's the probability of the event being all 1 through 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well, you have all 10 possibilities out of the 10 you can get altogether, 10 over 10, which you could reduce to 1, which is 100%. Again, a probability of 1 or 100% means something certain to occur.